With the recent balance update, a lot of towers have changed how they are played and what their stats are. So in this video, I want to take the time to go over Fracture and take a closer look at Fracture. Without further ado, let's jump straight into it. Unlike most towers in Tower Heroes, Fracture cannot be obtained from the in-game shop. It has to be earned by beating Volcano Valley or Canyon Calamity on any difficulty. Beating those maps will grant you Fracture and in some cases even special skins. Fracture is classified as a male character and its gender is currently unknown. You can only place 8 fractures per player on the map, so that is something to keep in mind. You can place down level 1 fracture for 85 mana. It will do 3 damage with a 2.5 range. The most incredible thing though is that it gets detection on level 1, making it good about early game ghosts. After being buried for a while, Fracture finally gets out of his grave at level 2, which can be obtained for 500 mana. It will do 8 damage and its range will become 7. Of course, it will still keep that nice detection. At level 3, which can be obtained for 1700 mana, we finally start to see one of the classic crystals that Fracture is known for. Its damage increases to a whopping 28 damage, but its range only increases to 9. Keep in mind that it still keeps detection. At level 4, Fracture starts to look like the Fracture that we all know and love. You can upgrade him to this level for 3000 mana. Its damage will increase to 40 and its range will increase to 10. It will keep detection. However, it also gets a new stat called cooldown, which is 1.8 seconds. And of course, last but not least, the fan favorite level of Fracture, level 5, can be obtained for 5000 mana. Its damage doesn't actually increase that much, only increasing to 48 damage. Its range increases to 11 and it still keeps detection. Its cooldown changes from 1.8 seconds to 1.7 seconds, making the damage a little bit more higher than it seems. Fracture also has some pretty nice exclusive skins. These include Petrified, Molten, and Ice Skeleton. Keep in mind that these exclusive skins cannot be earned from any crate. They have to be obtained as map rewards. But luckily, they aren't that difficult. All in all, I gotta say, Fracture is a super unique and awesome character to have on your team. And even is used quite a lot in the pro game. Even though people are still upset that they nerfed Fracture this hard, he is still an amazing and viable option. And when you want to speedrun maps, he is probably one of the towers that you want to have in your team. I really hoped you learned something new about Fracture today. But anyway guys, thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video and want to see more, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye!